Good morning and welcome to Unity of Las Cruces, where we know that God is good all the time. And we're glad to have you with us today if you are here on our Zoom, and we look forward to seeing others of you on YouTube. I am Kay Brilliant. I am a prayer chaplain with Unity of Las Cruces. And I'm going to turn this over to Tanya for an inspirational reading.
Thank you, Kay. This morning's inspirational reading is brought to you by Willie Nelson, the Tao of Willie. And this reading is a short one in his book. It's called The Golden Rule. You've heard of that before. Heaven is eternal, earth everlasting is the quote, the Tao Te Ching. Some people like to make a big deal about their particular telling of the religion. If your religion is an important part of your life, then I am happy for you without any regard for which religion it is. As far as different religions are concerned, to me, they're just different paths leading to the same place, 1,000 paths to a single destination. The Golden Rule is the main thing I live by, and every religion I've read about or studied, both East and West, has the Golden Rule as a common thread running through it. Every person is free to believe what the heck they want to. But if every person, every business, and every government simply followed the Golden Rule in all their decisions, everything else would just fall into place. Right. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Unfortunately, we don't always like things to be so simple. We like to talk about infinite shades of gray when the simple truth is right before us in black and white. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Thank you, Willie. And thank you, Kay.
Thank you, Tanya. And thank you, Willie, for all of that wisdom and your wonderful music. God is good all the time, and all are welcome, safe, and loved here at Unity of Las Cruces. And we're glad to have Helen Wright speak with us today, and her title, thank you, Willie, for helping, Many Paths Up the Mountain. So I hope you've put on your hiking boots. And now for good news from Ken Warner.
All right, thank you. Good morning, everybody. Let's see if we can get you up here. There's a lot of stuff going on out in the world with all this weather that's going on. Let me see if I can get the right slide up here. Just 1 second. And let's see if it'll let me do this. There we go.
Nice slide.
Let's do that. There we go. Surprise, that's me. Good morning, everybody. All right. So I don't usually put this on myself, so it's a little difficult finding the right tools to put myself in here. But I want to share this little thing that I found on the news, on the Good News Network today. And it's someone giving to the world around him. There's a guy out there that lives down in Texas, and you know all the weather they had going on downstairs in the Middle West and the Northern Texas and all the stuff that was going on with all the cold that was down there. And with people like we experienced here a couple of years ago with pipe bursts and losing power and water breaking and, you know, no utilities, it gets kind of scary out there when you're having to resort to like living in a cave with no utilities. And there's some people out there like this individual here, his name's Jim Mattress Mac McInvale. And he opened two of his gallery furniture locations down in Texas to go out and allow people to come in and basically stay and eat and survive within his stores out there, because he had heat, he had power, he had water, and he could give this back to the community around him. And he served within a 72-hour period during this last time over 3,000 meals and shared accommodations for more than 700 Houston residents by offering his stores. And you can see in the one of the picture here, this picture is from 2017 when he did it for some flood victims back at that time frame, where people just come in and hang out and live in his brand new furniture stores and going through and taking advantage of all those beds and the couches and places to sit and stay and have the cover and get out of the weather. And it was really kind of cool. He's been doing this now over many, many years, starting back in this first identified was back in 2005. And he's helped other people with Katrina and lots of different hurricanes. Tropical Storm Imelda back in 2019. He keeps doing this year after year after year as needed. He's really helped out his his community around him. So this is one thing that I wanted to show, that people have the ability to share, are doing so. And I think it's a wonderful way for people to see that there are people out there willing to help others in need. Thank you very much. Back to you.
Thank you, Ken. And for we enjoyed those good news stories. We will ask that if you find a good news story, that you share it with Ken by going to the website. Going to the email, unityoflascruces@gmail.com, and just put attention Ken Warner. And he'll go through the ones he gets, and we'll have a good news each week. Thank you. And now please join me in gratitude for all who work behind the scenes at Unity of Las Cruces to bring us our Sunday celebration and all of the other projects that we do. We are all Unity of Las Cruces, and we are grateful for anyone who enlivens our church, including those behind the scenes. Obviously, those of you who attend and those who are watching via YouTube. Our prayer chaplains, our Unity board, our social media outreach helpers and donors and tithers, anonymous prayers, musicians, speakers, including today's, and Zoom, your YouTube email producer. We know that that's Ken. Anything that has a button, that's Ken. Thank you for raising the vibrations of this universe through your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations, for allowing the love and light and healing to flow through you and others and to this planet. And today we are pleased to have Helen. Are you doing the opening prayer?
I am, unless you would like to.
Nope, go right ahead.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. And let's just take a moment and prepare for prayer. Just relax and let our shoulders drop a little, maybe. And follow our breath. Follow the in-breath, follow the out-breath. And as we follow the in-breath, bring our focus deeper within to our personal spiritual sanctuary, our place where we commune with the divine. And we say thank you to the loving, living Spirit of God, that divine love, that divinity in each of us. And this day we continue our focus on strength and tenacity and courage and going the distance and exploring some of the metaphors in terms of a mountain and our spiritual journeys. And we honor each one, everyone's individual spiritual journey. As the reading, we honor the spiritual path, each individual expressing their own unique individuality from that divinity within. And we also bring our focus to connection and knowing that we are connected. We're connected on this call with our hearts and our minds, and we're always connected through our hearts, through spirit, through that divine connection, and connecting no matter where any of us are, we are still connected because we are all one. So in loving gratitude for all that we are, all that we have, all that we receive, all that we give, we are so grateful, and we say thank you, God, and so it is. Amen.
Amen.
And now it's time in the service for the Daily Word, and today we welcome Dave Adie, who will be reading our Daily Word. Thank you, Dave.
Thank you, Helen. Good morning to all of you out there. The Daily Word for February 28, 2021 is connection. The affirmation is, I honor my connection with all people. No matter how great the distance that exists between me and the people I care about, I know we are connected by our love for one another. Today, I reestablish and strengthen this connection by reaching out, even if it's only to let someone know I'm thinking about them. Our connection is also kept strong through prayer. As I pray for those I care about, I bless them by holding my highest vision for their lives, seeing them as healthy, prosperous, happy, and fulfilled. Whether we're in frequent contact or have fallen out of touch, my connection with my loved ones remains strong because we are one in God, one in love. The scripture for today, for in the one spirit, we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of one spirit. This is from 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 13. And so it is. Amen.
And so it is, and thank you, Dave. Next, we have our foundation statement for unity.
Our foundation statement. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, God, the good omnipotence.
Thank you, Tanya. And now is the time for our talk. So as you heard earlier, the title of my talk is Many Paths of the Mountain. So again, good morning. It's so great to be here with you all. I'm so grateful to be here with this message. And this talk called Many Paths of the Mountain, partly because I'm weaving together two of the themes for this month. The unity theme is spiritual strength, based on the 12 powers of humans, or 12 faculties of humans. And in unity, the power of strength is often seen as a light or an energy of strength, a spiritual quality. And it combines stability and courage and tenacity. But also, I was combining the theme for the Center for Spiritual Living, which was one journey, many paths. And so this is the creation that comes out of those two themes. In Las Cruces, we know about mountains. We see mountains every day. But if we were in the Netherlands or if we were in the middle of the country, we may not know mountains quite as well as we know mountains in Las Cruces. When we see them every day, we see the sunrise over the Organ Mountains, the sunset, the different shades and hues and colors of the mountains, and then they become snow-covered, and that's a whole different experience. And in my thinking about mountains, it's been my experience that humans love mountains. We love to photograph them, we love to climb them or hike them or ski down them or bike on them. And some people, not me, love to jump off mountains and paraglide. They're also a really good metaphor for a journey, or a spiritual journey. Charles Fillmore in The Revealing Word said, "A mountain represents an exalted state of mind where the divine plan may be perceived and unfolded, a state of spiritual realization." He also continued in the Metaphysical Bible Dictionary saying, "This exaltation or high plane of consciousness is what the mountain can represent." And there are many people in the Bible who we hear the stories of them going up the Bible to pray or going up the Bible for spiritual inspiration. Moses was one of the figures in the Bible that went up the mountain, and we believe it could be Mount Sinai, which also means a higher plane of consciousness. And he went up the mountain twice, because the first time he received the Ten Commandments, they were broken. And so the second time he went back up and received the tablets, the stones, the commandments again. And Jesus went up many high places or many mountains. We know about the Mount of the Beatitudes, which is probably more accurately described as a hill, and that's in the Chorazin Plateau, and that's where he gave the Sermon on the Mount. and also the Mount of Olives, the place where he prayed and wept and ascended. So there's this concept of spiritual leaders in the scriptures going to a high place physically, because it's also comparing that with a high place in consciousness. So if we could have the first slide, Ken, that would be great. And so I looked at mountains like a typical, you know, apex triangle. And I apologize, apologies that this is not our A mountain, but it was the best A mountain photograph I could find. So even though it's not ours, you still get the idea of the A mountain. So the apex of the mountain is representing that higher consciousness for prayer and meditation. And the same mountain, we can have many paths to try and get up that mountain. And yet it's one journey, if we're looking at consciousness, it's one journey of continuing spiritual growth in consciousness as we ascend in consciousness, like we might ascend a physical mountain. And you can see from the wonderful A in the middle, if you were to stop at any point of the mountain, lower down where there's trees, halfway up, right at the top, there would be a different perspective, a different view. Last week, we got to see Lillian talking from further up the mountain where she lives. And we got to see, I'd never seen the perspective of seeing the White Sands National Monument from such a distance and from such a different perspective. So as we go up mountains physically, we can have a different view, a different perspective. So as we rise in consciousness, so too is a different perspective, a different viewpoint from a different level, a higher level of consciousness. So I was reading a little bit about the Organ Mountains and our A Mountain and the construction of it. Thank you, Ken. And mountaineers love to climb in the Organ Mountains. And there is a couple of people who are reported. Their names are Tailka and Kevin Boyko. I hope I've got their names right. And they may be the first people to have climbed all 30 peaks of the Organ Mountains. And they did that in 38 hours, no stopping, no sleeping. That is definitely not on my bucket list. But just this draw, this pull, this attraction of the mountains and being at those high peaks. And I love mountains myself. I've done a lot of walking and gentle hiking in mountains. But even if I was to consider that A mountain, the Tortugas Mountain, there's still preparation that needs to be done for any physical journey up a mountain. There needs to be practice. You need to get fit. You need to get accustomed to the activity that a person is going to be doing. You need the right gear. Here in Las Cruces, you certainly need water. You may need lessons and teaching and practice sessions. And then you might want to tackle the most direct path up the mountain, or you might want to meander around or meander all the way around the mountain as you ascend. You might want to traverse back and front, back and forth. And that's exactly what I did at the White Sands, because I really wanted my feet in the White Sands, in that gypsum. And I also wanted my bare feet to climb one of those hills of the sand dunes. But also, being a little practical, I decided to do what was within my physical capabilities of just traversing rather than going straight up and probably falling flat on my face, who knows. So coming back to this concept of practice in both the climbing physical mountains and the metaphorical mountain of the high place, where there's a higher consciousness, that place of prayer and meditation and realization, both of those require practice. And both of them can require all of the spiritual qualities of strength. Both can require courage and tenacity and that stability with flexibility. And in both cases, there's choice. We have choice whether to practice. We have choice whether to do our spiritual practice or how much of it. And so we, each individual, has free will. We have free will, we have choices, and it's ours to choose. Certainly how much effort we want to put into our spiritual practice and in what means we do our spiritual practice. So whenever I'm preparing for a talk, I always find plenty of real life examples that show up in my life. And you probably, most of you know that I'm doing some extra work, some extra interviews for this path towards ordination with Unity Worldwide Ministries. And they had a webinar called Three Paths Up the Mountain, talking about the three different paths towards ordination with Unity Worldwide Ministries. There's actually a fourth path too, but they didn't go into because that was an international path from students of truth around the world. But the three paths they were talking about was the Unity Urban Ministerial School path, the Unity Worldwide Spiritual Institute path, and then the Field Program path, which is the path I'm taking. And as a really human student, and being very, very human and being very studenty, my first thought about these three paths up the mountain was, okay, which is the easiest? Which is the cheapest? And which is the fastest? And there were a few other of those really sort of studenty questions too. And the answer to that was really clear for me from meditation, was that those questions are irrelevant from a spiritual viewpoint. From the spiritual viewpoint, any of the paths are designed to grow in consciousness and to help the prospective minister grow in consciousness. So at that point, I was able to relax and, you know, more gracefully ease into the trust, the faith, the spiritual strength, and all will be well. In God, all things are possible. Also made me think about this concept of an individualized education plan. Any of you who have been teachers or worked with special needs children know about the IEP, the individualized education plan. And that's worked out specifically for the student, specifically to meet their needs and maximize or optimize their ability to learn. So Unity Worldwide Ministry Field Ministry Program is a totally individualized program. So after a couple of weeks of interviews and everything, they will come up with a plan for me that is totally unique to my life experience so far. And they will then determine this individual program. So if you were to ask me how long will it take, I don't know. It will depend on the individualized program. How much work, what type of work, what type of classes, it's all based on this individual program. And I realize in the wider scheme of things, that's what we're all doing. We all have our individualized educational learning program for this life on earth. And we may have chosen this, if you believe in reincarnation, we may have chosen this as a pre-planning committee. What experiences did we want to have in this incarnation? What experience would help bring us further into deeper spiritual understanding? And that also means that we can't compare. We have no idea where anyone is on their own spiritual path. And it's really not helpful to even begin to compare because each one is unique and an individual. So in contemplating further this many paths, one journey, what came to mind was the concept of many mansions. And that is from John 14, verses 1 to 4. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. So this many, many mansions, Truth Unity has a metaphysical interpretation of this. And they look at it as many mansions can be translated as many different abodes. and that there is a universal mind essence, which science names the ether. And the ether mind identifies itself with the ether and first builds thoughts. Out of those thoughts, it builds things. And Jesus is said to have been the master builder because he built a mansion, huge state of consciousness. And as God is spirit, therefore his home, his her home must be spiritual in essence. And these abodes represent states of spiritual consciousness. I then went to Paramahansa Yogananda, Hindu, from the Self-Realization Fellowship and from the Yogoda Satsanga Society of India. And here also is another metaphysical interpretation of that passage from John. It says, do not trouble your hearts, the feeling aspect of consciousness. Keep your meditation-born spiritual perception fixed on the imperturbability, the calm, the steadiness of cosmic consciousness beyond creation and Christ consciousness present in all creation. Many mansions, regions differing in their vibration are where souls dwell according to their earth-acquired vibration. Vibration consciousness determines which abode a soul may be in. And it's talking about the next life of souls on a soul spiritual journey. And that also made me think about all the different rooms in my house and perhaps different rooms or abodes even in mind, in consciousness. And my own experience of this many mansions, I'd heard it many times growing up. And I really had a vision. This is England Gardens. I had a vision that this meant that there would be many high-walled gardens and all the people in one garden could not see up and over the wall into the next people. So I had this sort of image, a literal image of many different walled gardens or many different abodes, and that's where all the different religions were. And because I was most familiar with Roman Catholic or Methodist or Muslim when I was growing up in Britain, then every one of these groups might be in a different walled garden. And, you know, this was all determined by vibration. So if I may share the next slide, it also made me smile because it looked like my cats were trying to teach me about different abodes or different aspects. So the black and white cat is my new foster kitty, and the grey cat is Puma. And socially distanced, they were about 6 feet apart and back to back, not looking, not paying attention, not wishing to look, not wishing to engage. And I kind of had that image for this many mansions where different people have different vibrations, different beliefs because of the different chosen paths, were not necessarily wishing to look at each other like the cats until awareness had grown to the point where they could peek over the tops of the walls. That was one of my own sort of impressions growing up. Thank you, Ken. So we can look at this concept of many mansions. Then we can also come back to thinking about this conscious spiritual journey. And we can see this journey as our life path in this incarnation. It's a journey, and certainly there may be many paths or many interweavings of paths as we move along our life path, just as we might see going up a mountain, the many options, many faiths, many different spiritual practices. And so now if we can have the slide of the organ mountains. So when we see mountains, and again, it's a metaphor for our spiritual journey, we might want to meander around, maybe the A mountain, a smaller mountain, just meander around and gently proceed up the mountain. We might stop in a lush forest, not necessarily on the organ mountains, but on a lush forest, there may be a stream, and that might be as far as we want to go. Or we might go, want to go halfway up the mountain, get a really good view at that point and say, aha, that's enough. I might need more training, I might need more practice, and I might be able to go further up the mountain when I've done more practice and more training. We might decide that, like those two people who were reported to have gone across every peak of the Ogden Mountains, we might go want to go right to the top of the steepest peak of the mountain. Or we might decide that, you know, halfway up the mountain was perfectly fine for this lifetime, and we could pick it up in another lifetime. Speed isn't necessarily valuable in terms of the spiritual journey, because it takes time to grow this consciousness. So Charles Fillmore said that prayer is the most highly accelerated mind action known to humans. And it's this highly accelerated mind action of prayer that can take us further up in consciousness. And so, he really sort of focused on the fact that prayer is important, our spiritual practice is important. And he also went on to say that this spiritual mind action, this accelerated mind action of prayer, it steps up mental action until man's consciousness synchronizes with the Christ mind. It is the language of spirituality when developed, it makes man fast master in the realm of creative ideas. And we practice prayer in order to experience an elevating of consciousness that our hearts and minds might open to receive guidance and healing and a greater awareness of the divine that is our truest nature. And prayer is closely related to meditation. There's many forms of meditations, guided visualization, focusing on a word, a sound, breathing. There's many ways to do meditation, but there's also the importance of the silence from unity's perspective, where we really are in that place of communion with the divine. And I keep referring to spiritual practice. It doesn't have to be, I can say, the whole enchilada right away. We can take it a little bit at a time. When I took a class through Unity on meditation, they brought the example of a 1 minute meditation that we could do at any point of the day, just for 1 minute. And that was beneficial. And Eric Butterworth says, in terms of the silence, that we don't have to spend long in the silence, just a few moments in that deep silence of that space of the place of the Most High is all that is needed. So you don't need to do what I did when I first went to Findhorn. I thought Findhorn, it was great, it was wonderful. I did a week transformation class and immediately signed up to come back for 4 weeks of silent meditation. Now, I hadn't meditated before, so I jumped in with a 4 week silent meditation. Doesn't have to be that way. We don't have to go charging up the face of the mountain. We can just take everything at our own pace, our own unique pace. And so as we prepare for prayer and meditation, I'm going to transition from this talk into a guided meditation of a mountain and our spiritual practice. So if you just take a moment, we have some beautiful mountains if you like to gaze with a soft focus on the mountains and a path towards the mountains. Or you may wish to close your eyes, whatever feels most comfortable. Just taking this moment to go within. Go to our personal sanctuary. Go to the place of the Most High. And in our mind's view, we're going to take a gentle journey. This journey is taken at your own pace and just as far or just as filled with grace and ease and comfort as you visualize and bring forth for yourself. And you can start by visualizing your own personal mountain. whether it's got snow and peaks or whether it's got lush green forests as its base, whether it's a tropical mountain or a mountain in a cold place, or whether it's a mountain you know well. And just gently begin to walk, to amble at whatever pace is comfortable to you. And just looking ahead, be inspired by the light of God to light your path, your own personal path, along this hill, this mountain. And as we continue, we are gently scanning for a place where we might take some respite and rest and relax. Might be beside a stream or a waterfall, might be beside a tree, might be on a beautiful, smooth rock with a view for miles and miles. And as we find that place, we just sit, stand, lie down, whatever is most comfortable. And as we reflect on our own spiritual journey, our own spiritual path, we take whatever ideas, whatever thoughts might come to mind, and we take these gently, allowing them to be in our own internal landscape as we gently step in and enjoy a short time in the silence. And as we enter now into that silence, and gently, very gently, we bring our awareness back to our present moment. We can visualize ourselves stretching, we can stretch literally here in this present moment, and visualize our walk back down that path, and maybe another path will spring ahead of us that we can follow. Just coming back down to the mountain, to the place that we began. But as we are in this place we began, we are transformed. We are healed. We are changed. We are whole because of this time we've spent in the silence and in our spiritual practice. And we can know that we can go within at any time to find that silence, to find that place of realization, that place of new beginnings and changes of thought, of changes of mind that can change our lives. And so now we wiggle, like stretch our fingers, toes, take a deep breath and become fully present back in this moment. Fully back in this present moment with all of the gifts that we receive when we spend time in the silence. And now just I invite you to bask in a musical meditation as we go to Barry Shaw, music director of Unity Las Cruces, and Max Contreras. And the song title is Climb Every Mountain. You may know it.
attend. Search high and low. Follow every byway, every path you know. Climb every mountain.
Please join me in prayer as we affirm our prayer of faith. God is my help in every need. God does my every hunger feed. God dwells within me, guides my way through every moment, night and day. I now am wise, I now am true, patient, kind, and loving too. All things I am, can do and be through Christ, the truth that is in me. God is my health, I can't be sick. God is my strength, unfailing quick. God is my all, I know no fear, since God and love and truth are here. Amen.
Our tithe recipient for this week is the Daily Word. And again, we just hold our tithe in our imagination, in our hands, and we bless it with our love. And we see it moving out into the world. We see it moving out to Daily Word, and the Daily Word goes out through into the world and helping people have this source of inspiration. And so we are grateful for the giving and the receiving and the opportunity to be able to tithe. So it is.
Welcome to Unity of Las Cruces, where we know that God is good all the time. Your love blessings can be made at the Unity of Las Cruces website or on the weekly email. You can mail your gift, donation, or tithe to the P.O. Box. Your gift is given in love, goes out to the others in love, and love returns tenfold. And so it is.
And thank you for all of you for continuing to tithe by all of the different methods seen here on this slide. The March speakers, there's been a few changes, and we're so grateful that Reverend Tanya will be able to speak on the 14th. We have Reverend Alden next week, followed by George McGuffey, LUT from Arizona, from Unity of Green Valley, and then Reverend Alden Studebaker will be coming back to close out the month of March. Our Daily Word, Welcome the Word on Wednesdays, continues, and please join us. We have a wonderful, thoughtful time, prayerful time. Our Unity of Las Cruces annual general meeting is next week. I can hardly believe that we'll be into the first, at the end of the first week of March by next Sunday. And so it is our annual general meeting, and then all by Zoom. And then you will see on the next slide that we are inviting you all to have a look at the Unity Las Cruces website. It's a newly revised, renewed website. And much thanks to Reverend Tanya for a lot of the work that she did on the website, including we have our proposed new bylaws that we really would like and appreciate you to take a look at, comparing them with the old bylaws. And then we can vote on that and other topics on next week after the service. Reminder that we have ongoing donations, and just please call ahead. I believe Kathy Lady is usually there for probably 2 or 3 hours on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays. But if you have donations, it's really helpful to call ahead. Thank you. Thank you all for being here for this virtual service. And thank you again for Kay for leading us through the worship leader, platform assistant, connecting all of the pieces in such a wonderful way. And thank you, Reverend Tanya, for the inspirational reading. I loved it. And for the affirmation for unity. And of course, thank you to our musicians. That was absolutely beautiful. From Barry Shaw and Max Contreras, the Climb Every Mountain. Trust that you all enjoyed it too. I really loved that one. So please continue to our connection, our theme from the Daily Word. Please continue to stay connected this week and every week, and continue to connect with each other. And we will join together again for next week's virtual Sunday celebration, followed by the annual general meeting. Please stay after this service and we can catch up and talk. And now we have the prayer for protection and the peace song.
Please join us as we affirm the prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. Amen.
Indeed, thank you. And I also wanted to pay a special thank you and gratitude to Dave Adey, who is reading our daily word, and also a thank you for John Powers, who's has this recorded and may still be joining us at times for the daily word. So thank you both. Thank you, Ken, for all of the juggling of the slides and making all of that work so well. And so for everyone, just be strong, spiritual strong, be peace and be blessed as we go out into this day and this week. Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste.